Gentlemen, for me, one of the most harmful and insidious aspects of getting older is the decline in cognitive function. You know, the senior moment, the deteriorating memory, the diminishing focus, the dwindling motivation. It's almost like your brain is just operating at a diminished capacity. And guess what? It is, but it doesn't have to be that way. This is Lance Hitchings, and I created this channel to be a record of everything that I've learned on my quest to turn back the clock. And not only what I've learned, but the plans that I've made as a result of what I've learned, and the results that I've achieved through the implementation of those plans. And I created a new series of videos that focuses that lens on the subject of nootropics, which are a class of supplements that have been developed to improve cognitive function. Now, in today's video, the first in a series of three, I'm going to talk a bit about the brain and how it functions, and then introduce the subject of nootropics, give a little history, and talk a bit about the relationship between how the brain works and some of the benefits of taking nootropics. In the next two videos, I'll talk about neurotransmitters and their role in mental function, the different types of nootropics, how to take nootropics, and the results that I've gotten from taking them. So let's jump in by talking about how the brain functions. When people talk about brain cells, they're talking about neurons. Neurons are electrically excitable cells that process and transmit information through electrochemical signaling. Unlike other cells in our bodies, neurons never divide and they don't die off to be replaced by newer ones. And they typically can't be replaced after being lost. There are about 100 billion neurons in the average human brain, and each neuron has the capacity to connect to up to 10,000 other neurons. This connection takes the form of a synapse, and there are as many as a quadrillion synaptic connections in the brain. That's 1,000 trillion. The brain is a very malleable organ. It constantly adapts to external influences. It creates new synapses, new pathways for processing information. It rewires itself in a process called synaptogenesis, which is not only the creation of new synapses, but also the maintenance of existing synapses. Synaptogenesis is just part of an ability called neuroplasticity, and our brains retain this ability to create new synapses throughout our entire lives. But as we age, the brain's plasticity begins to diminish. It's less able to create new pathways or synapses. In fact, some pathways collapse. Synapses slow down or stop firing, and cognitive function is impaired. Enter nootropics. In simple terms, nootropics are synthetic compounds that improve cognitive function in healthy individuals. Now, you may or may not remember the movie Limitless, starring Bradley Cooper, or be familiar with the TV show based on the movie. But they're both about people who raise their cognitive abilities to extraordinary heights by using a mysterious drug called NZT. And while NZT may be pure fantasy, it may not be that far away. And there are supplements that you can take today that claim to improve your cognitive function. These supplements belong to a class of chemical compounds called nootropics. Now, the term nootropic is derived from the prefix noo, meaning of the mind, and the medical suffix tropic, meaning to turn either away from or towards a stimulus. And it was coined in 1972 by the Romanian chemist Corneliu Georgia to describe compounds that could turn the mind. Also known as smart drugs, or cognitive enhancers, these drugs, supplements, or other substances may improve cognitive function, particularly executive functions, memory, creativity, or motivation. However, a word of caution here. While there are a bunch of substances that are purported to enhance cognitive function, the research is still in the preliminary stages, and the effects of a lot of these substances is not fully determined. We're not talking about something that will affect the way that you feel, but rather the way that your mind functions. And that can be really hard to perceive, especially if it's not a really large increase. When your brain works better, it feels so natural that it's difficult to notice. Back in 2008, the primary class of these drugs that was in use at the time were stimulants, such as caffeine. But then college students started diverting ADHD stimulants, such as Ritalin, and they used these drugs not recreationally, but rather to enhance their academic performance, and thus began the quest for substances that can enhance human cognition, such as the fabled NZT. And for the aging male, these substances can be of importance as we see our cognitive functions in decline. And I'm not talking about Alzheimer's here. I'm talking about the simple decline in memory, in focus, in executive function. Now, I'm really lucky. There's no history of Alzheimer's or any type of senility in my family history on either side, as far as I know. But I've definitely seen a loss of memory and focus in the last 10 or 20 years. And trying to get some of that back is a primary concern to most aging men. Now, as I've said, research is still in the preliminary stages, and the effects of a lot of these substances are not yet fully determined. So all I can do is to share with you my own experience of nootropics and tell you about the results that I feel I've achieved. Now, while there's no formal criteria for what qualifies as a nootropic, Dr. Georgia felt that for any substance to be called a nootropic, it must enhance memory and learning ability, it must help the brain function under disruptive conditions, it must protect the brain from harmful chemical damage, it must improve neuronal firing mechanisms, and it must lack any sedative, stimulant, or toxic effects. So, given all of this, it's not too difficult to imagine why an aging man might want to try nootropics. There are a lot of reasons and a lot of potential benefits why someone might choose to explore this class of supplements. They might be looking for a boost in drive and motivation, in the ability to get things done and finish important tasks. Recently, nootropics have been used in pre-workout shakes to provide that extra motivation to ensure that exercises get performed in a way that takes advantage of their full potential. Or they might be looking for an improvement in clarity, focus, and attention. Attention underlies many other cognitive functions, and nootropics may help with several different aspects of attention, improving focused attention, selective attention, alternating attention, and divided attention. They might be looking for an increase in their memory and their ability to learn and retain new material. Nootropics can improve both short-term and long-term memory, as well as free recall. They can optimize performance-oriented memory functions and help with age-related memory issues. Or perhaps they're looking to improve their mood. Nootropics can boost the feeling of well-being by acting as anxiety aids, antidepressants, and mood enhancers. Or they might be looking for a boost in these social abilities. Nootropics can provide benefits in confidence, extroversion, and verbal fluidity, making them ideal for public speaking, presentations, and, well, really any social activity. Nootropics can also fuel energy consumption in the brain, boosting performance and reducing brain fatigue. They can reduce stress and improve sleep. Now, these are all short-term benefits, but nootropics have a number of long-term benefits that make them particularly attractive. They can protect against the aging effects of free radicals. They can deliver neuroprotective benefits, stimulating the generation of new neurons and overall supporting brain health by improving brain resilience, neuroplasticity, and neurogenesis. From my point of view, nootropics are worth learning about and worth exploring. There's just so many potential benefits. There's a lot to learn and a vast array of different types of nootropics with different benefits. In the next video, I'll be going into a lot of the different types of nootropics and I'll be listing the benefits for each. I'll also discuss the different neurotransmitters, the role that they play in cognition, and the effects that nootropics have on them. In the final video in this series, I'll wrap it up by getting into how to take nootropics, and I'll be talking about the results that I've personally achieved from taking them. If you enjoyed this video, then please subscribe to my channel, share it with your friends and on your social media, hit the like button, and leave a comment. And be sure to hit the bell to be notified when I post a new video, which should be every Tuesday, with bonus videos on the occasional Friday. And as always, thank you so much for watching.